council abilities to dictate things.
In interest of orders, you the act right in the national.
President Biden and his campaign was defined by a single issue.
COVID-19.
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 Now is faced with the challenge of delivering on his promise to make government effective again.
We will be judged, you and I, by how we resolve these cascading places of our earth.
And NBC News focused 11% of voters say vaccine administration has been going very well. Among those who say delivery falls short, 64% blame the federal government.
We put hours, 2 or 3 hours at a time, after the federal law.
The president is doubling down on his pledge to deliver 100 million vaccinations in his first 100 days.
We need more vaccine, we need more vaccine, we need more vaccine.
And the administration is already struggling now, investing in this year's economy.
He's certainly not starting from scratch because there is activity going on in the distribution.
President Biden now faces two challenges, taking the red state Republican governors as a partner.
He shouldn't be the Hunger Games like it was with PPE,
including some Trump allies who are dismissive of his plan.
I saw some of the stuff that Biden's putting out. He's got a crazy screen up there and throw it out. I'm like, that's not necessary to throw it.
And forging enough cooperation with Republicans in Washington to deliver on his ambitious agenda.
Requires the most elusive of all things in the democracy. Unity.
The President Biden's calls about how temperature of the middle screens, the building faces limits to front of positive attention.
President Biden's sample of measured neutral that is normally addressed in vision on the dynamics. The implementing of all the process will be the Democrats
and agreeing ground rules for one dissent, especially when it comes to the filibuster.
Not only have you been but really, they're a little hard to agree. And certainly, we're up. At least, actually, Greg, in this standing here, and he said, leaving McConnell's proposal is unacceptable. It won't be accepted.
Biden Economic Advisor Brian Deese is scheduled to meet a bipartisan group of senators in a call today to push Biden's $1.9 trillion COVID relief plan. And while President Biden urges Congress to tackle his priorities quickly,
no time we have to get up and running and make these questions with the governor.
A Senate impeachment trial.
Presentation by the parties will commence the week of February the 8th.
They make it harder to both change the tone and delay passage of his agenda.
Sometimes we can't assist a bad person from the presidency and continues to divide the nation.
I don't think it's very uniform to say, oh, let's just forget it and move on.
Change your shampoo right now if you don't want this to happen. It has the same ingredients as dish soap. I'm a 38-year-old guy with no pattern baldness. I've been suffering hair loss and cuts. $1,000 in hair loss by online system shopping malls. Maybe it's a good.
Oh, join me now as President Biden's chief of staff, Ron Klain, Mr. Klain.
Welcome back to Meet the Press and Dave Hill, I believe, of this presidency. So let me start with a contradiction, a potential contradiction. Jeff Zients, your COVID-19 coordinator, indicated that you guys had to build this vaccine distribution program from scratch. Dr. Fauci and the White House briefing room said, no, we're not building it from scratch. Give me an assessment now, after 3 or 4 days of this, of what you inferred in this vaccine distribution program.
I think, Chuck, those two statements actually reconcile more than you mentioned. I think what Dr. Fauci is saying is, of course, a year of really amazing scientific breakthrough and discovery created this vaccine in record time. And we have seen the initial wave of vaccinations take place. That is progress. We are good now. There's no question about it. But the process to distribute the vaccine, particularly outside of nursing homes and hospitals, out of the community as a whole, we not really just maintain anything more than us. As every American has seen, the way in which people get vaccine is chaotic, it's very limited. We've seen this fact all over the country where millions of doses have been distributed, about half of that has been given out. So the process of getting that vaccine into arms, that's the hard process. That's where we're defined as a country, and that's where we're focused in the Biden administration on getting that ramped up.
Let me ask something very specific on that. We have about a 20 million dose gap, right, of what's been distributed and what's gotten into people's arms. Where is the holdups? Is this on the states and how they've been distributing? We all have personal experiences. My mother's in Florida. And need I say more about what we've lost in Florida? What is this gap?
they get more closer with the manufacturer, they get that production. One of the first orders the president signed was music was needed at home and defense electron to mandate the production of more vials that can extract more doses out of more syringes that can extract more doses out of the existing vaccine vials. So we're going to use all the power we have in the White House. We're going to work with Congress to get more funding to also solve this so we can improve the way that we're vaccinating.
When you set out the 100 million vaccinations in the first 100 days before the election, before we had a vaccine, it was considered both aspirational at the time, and at the same time, yeah, we better meet that goal. So I guess, where are we now on that goal in your mind? And is there a point where you're going to raise the bar when new vaccines come online?
So Chuck, I think it is a very bold and ambitious goal. When you wrote about just before the inauguration, but the Biden presidency, we measured by this goal. We understand that. We took responsibility for that. And I think it is this country has never given 100 million shots for 100 days. So if we can do that, I think it would be part of the accomplishment. But obviously, we're not going to stop there. When 100 million people, 100 million shots is a goal, an ambitious goal, but we need to keep going after that. So that is our goal, that is our first goal. It's not our final goal, it's not the end point, it's just a metric that the American people can watch and measure on how we do it.
But as you know, there's always going to be a lot of people second-guessing a lot of things. So here we are asking about vaccine distribution, and now we're asking about vaccine skepticism. Hank Aaron's death. Robert Kennedy Jr. jumped on Hank Aaron's death because 18 days before he died, he was vaccinated. Here's Robert F. Kennedy's tweet. Hank Aaron's tragic death is part of a wave of suspicious deaths among elderly closely following the administration of COVID vaccine. This was something that the rest of the world about, a lot of people learned about, but the anti-vaxxers who take advantage of situations like this, how do you kind of put it?
Chuck, this is a great point. It's a great concern. We have a lot of people who want to get the vaccine, who can't get it, and why are we worried about the people who don't want to get the vaccine? Well, we have to worry about those people because unless we can reduce vaccine hesitancy, unless we can get all Americans to take this vaccine, we're going to continue to see COVID be a problem in our country. So we have appointed our task force. First of all, one focus on health equity. We have a lot of this hesitancy located in communities of color. We're going to tackle that problem. The trusted communicators, the direct on-the-ground communication, try to win over those people who are vaccine hesitant. We're going to obviously try to work with the social media companies to lessen the amount of this information that's available online and get the truth out there. And of course, the president himself has tried to set the example that his vaccination in public, so as being the vice president, to try to show people that the vaccine is safe and effective. This is a big challenge, Chuck. There's no question about it. Something we'll be working on every day.
One more thing on vaccine distribution. A couple of governors have talked about trying to purchase vaccines directly from Governor Whitmer, Michigan, Governor Cuomo, New York, and into the dish. Is that helpful to you, or could that actually make your job harder?
Well, I think, Chuck, as a matter of law, this vaccine is under an emergency use authorization. I don't think that's possible. I understand why the governors are frustrated, and I understand they're frustrated. And we're going to ramp up production, we're going to ramp up distribution, we're going to work closely with governors, we're going to get this vaccine to the American people. It is going to be bumpy. There are going to be present and now just there are going to be setbacks, there are going to be bad days. But we're working on this card every single day, and I'm coming back on this program to discuss it again and again. And you can hold me to account whether or not we make progress.
I want to ask about COVID. Here's what Huntsville reported about Speaker Pelosi on Saturday. Speaker Nancy Pelosi told voters on the Zoom call Thursday night that she wanted to pass Biden's budget relief bill in 2 weeks using budget reconciliation. Look, I think a lot of us have identified that congressional Democratic leadership may have much less patience than President Biden has in trying to find bipartisan cooperation. What is that level of patience? How much patience does President Biden have in trying to find 10 Republicans and avoid having to do this on a program?
Well, we're going to move fast and we're going to move bipartisan. As you said at the top of the show, the president's chief economic advisor is meeting by phone, Zoom today. with 16 senators, 8 Democrats, 8 Republicans, we're reaching out to people. I don't think that partisanship and speed are enemies of one another. The need is urgent. Americans, both Democrats and Republicans, are dying. Kids' schools, the future of both Democratic and Republican kids, are closed. People are unemployment. People are in food lines. That's not a party issue. So I think let's try to move on a bipartisan basis. Let's try to move quickly. Speed is very important.
Are we willing, for instance, to table the push for upping the minimum wage if it got to the 10 Republicans you needed? And about everything else?
I'm not going to negotiate on meet the press. Our goal is to raise the minimum wage. It's something that, well, doesn't seem like it's the most effective way to get things done, in my view. But look, here's the point, though, which is the president put a plan for the country. And I think that's what the country wanted to do. You know, I think, again, without delving back in the past, I think we didn't have this kind of leadership before. He said, here's what needs to happen. And we're very dedicated to passing the minimum wage. We think that's an urgent priority. We're going to push the Congress to pass our priorities, and that includes the minimum wage. And so what we want to do is work with the Congress, reach out to members of both parties, see what we can get done as quickly as possible. You certainly think the minimum wage should be part of this urgent relief plan.
I want to ask you about the relationship already with Senate Republicans, Mitch McConnell, Joe Biden, and other ones, personal history. How would you describe the cooperation you've gotten so far from Senate Republicans?
No, Chuck, I think by and large, we've seen a lot of progress on this front. Obviously, we've got some Senate hearings held by Republican-led committees for our nominees before the switchover here this past week. We've seen obviously two of our cabinet nominees confirmed already, Rebecca Hill, Secretary Austin, and we hope to get votes on a number of others this week. But I wish we could get real less Republican blocking on Secretary Desmond Mayorkas. It's very important to have a head of Homeland Security. It's a critical need. Our homeland obviously is always under threats. I wish we could move that a little faster. Hopefully we'll see progress this week. But we're grateful to Senate Republicans who work with us on these national security nominees.
Is President Biden ever going to tell the public how he would vote, how he wants senators to vote on the impeachment trial? Is that something he will share publicly before the trial vote?
I don't know, Chuck. I mean, I think he's busy doing his job, as a being president, just in these places we've been talking about. He's not a senator. He's not debate on impeachment. So I think his focus is on being president, not on doing the job he needs to have, which is being a U.S. senator.
Ron Feiner is about 7,000 other issues I'd like to ask some questions about, but I can tackle them. I don't think I one bite at a time. You get up this thing and I'll just go and stop the question about it. Is there any chance Democrats and Republicans can work together, especially with another impeachment trial on the way? I'll talk to Senators Dick Durbin and Mike Brown. Dr. Max Molly, Speaker Nancy Pelosi will walk the House's single article of impeachment against my former President Trump. That will trigger the start of the trial process, but that will be delayed for 2 weeks. Give both sides time to prepare their cases. Perhaps it's under consideration. There's never been an impeachment trial of a former president. All of the murder to jeopardize the school community, President Biden has been. So joining me now are the Senate Democratic Whip, Dick Durbin, and the Republican Senator Ron Johnson. Welcome both of you. Senator Durbin, I'm going to start this interview with you. Let me start with sort of the complication of negotiating COVID relief without the impeachment trial. Let me ask this. Is it realistic at all that we can come to a compromise, find your 10 Republicans before February, and get this going really fast, or is that a little hard?
Well, I hope what happened is American people know we're in the midst of a deadly pandemic. The economy has been damaged and struggling. The rescue package that President Biden has sent to us is one of the highest importance and sense of urgency. So I hope we can do more of those things and get that done in that period of time that you mentioned.
What is the role you would like President Biden to play in these negotiations for the relief? And how much patience do you have to work with Republicans versus most people Pelosi is ready to just go now to budget reconciliation? How much time do you have?
Well, I think
can tell you, I think among some Republicans in the Senate, there's
Thank you.
I'm sorry. What's your name, Stitch, and then you? Yes, the dog is as much pain.
I'm sorry, sir. I touched the tape back on accident.